We're here backstage with Mikkel Slikk Mikk Lespierre. Now 12-0 here in the professional ranks, still undefeated, came out here and did what he needed to get done. But Mick walks through the fight a little bit, talk to us, you know, how you felt out there tonight.
I felt good condition-wise. It's just that, you know, the compromisation of my weight, you know, fighting above my weight, you know, I'm fighting junior welterweights, and I'm not a junior welterweight, I'm a 140 pound. I'm probably like 151 pounds right now, where he's probably like 160, above 160. But, you know, I felt good. It's just that, you know what I'm saying, the weight always throws me off, you know. I don't have the same crack at 47 as I would at 40. So, you know, I have to improvise. I have to use my skill, you know, to win the fight, basically, and hold my own. So, you know, I just do what I got to do, you know, to make the adjustments to win the fight. You know, this is my third fight of the year compromising my weight. It's been pretty close, but, you know, like I said, it's the weight, you know. But we getting it done. That's all that matters.
Absolutely. 12-0 is all that matters. But you're in there with an awkward guy, Mick. You know, you're able to do your thing. You kept turning him, working behind a jab well, kept your shell up well to block what he was doing. You know, but kind of walk me through, you know, the difficulty of dealing with a fighter that's just as awkward as he was.
He was just winging, you know. And I was trying to catch him in between the punches. Even if I do catch the punch, trying to counter off it, but after he'll throw his punch, he'll wing it, and then he'll fall on top of me, and he'll come in with his head. He headbutt me with his head like three times. The second time he cut me, you know, he was just awkward, you know what I'm saying? So I'm just glad that I came out with the victory, you know. I couldn't get off what I wanted to get off, but as long as I kept my jab, you know, dominant, which I did, that, you know, landed most of the points, and that's what won me the fight.
Absolutely. And Mick, you're always somebody that does a really good job of staying disciplined. And it's got to be difficult when you're in there with a guy that I think he got a warning for every single thing in the rule book at least once. But, you know, for a guy that's trying to take you out of your game like that, how do you maintain the discipline to not fall into the antics and, you know, and do something that's not characteristic of you?
Just strategizing, you know, every time. Being that I know that he was so wild and he was the bigger guy, I said, you know, if he come in close and try to throw his wild punches, grab him, hold him. Make the ref break us apart. You know, that'll slow his momentum down and get me right back in the middle of the middle of the ring. But, you know, it's all about strategizing and making best of your game plan. And that's what I did try to do 100% today. You know, I kind of went off track a little bit. I wanted to be a little bit more aggressive. But, you know, I just stuck to the game plan and did what I knew how to do best in order to get the win.
No doubt about it, Mick, and to wrap everything up for us, 2016 is now underway. 2015 was a very busy year for you, but, you know, 2016 started on the right note. What are some things you hope to accomplish in this upcoming year?
I just want to get in the top 20 ranking, start fighting guys my weight and not, you know, these shows at compromised weights. You know, that way I can be labeled as a junior welterweight and not someone that fluctuates between junior welterweight and welterweight. And then I want to get accustomed to going down to my weight, you know, because compromising my weight does a lot, you know. So I just want to stay active and get in that top 20 or top 30, just get closer to the rankings, you know what I'm saying, and so I could fight somebody of caliber and show people that I am a good junior welterweight, I am a skilled welterweight, and I can get the job done and I could take it to the next level.
There you have it. Mikkel Lespierre, now 12-0. As always, Mick, got to thank you for all the courtesy and everything you show us over here on this side. And any closing remarks you got for the people out there?
I just want to say thank everybody for supporting me, especially Resolution Sports. Like I said, from day one, my boy John, he's you know, he's been there showing support and capturing every moment, good, bad, the ugly. You know, I just appreciate John himself, and I just want to appreciate everybody. I just want to send a thank you to everybody that supports Slikk Mikk.
There you have it. Onwards and upwards we go. Appreciate it, Mick.